வந்தே வாஞ்சிதலாபாய கர்ம கிம் தன்ன கத்தியதே கிம் தம்பதி மதில் ப்ரூயாம் உதாகோ தம்பதி இதி. ஸோ யூ சா த டிஸ்கிரிப்ஷன் ஆஃப் அமராவதி இன் த லாஸ்ட் கிளாஸ். அண்ட் த நெக்ஸ்ட் ஒன் இஸ் டாக்ஸ் அபவுட் ஹவு வாட் இஸ் த ஹவு கேன் வி பை ஹவுசஸ் அண்ட் ஹவு கேன் வி லிவ் இன் அமராவதி. Right? It is the punya phalam with which you go to Amaravati or the Swargam, and with your punya phalam you are going to attain everything that is there in that city. So he is thinking about what could be the money or transaction. You need something to go about in Swargam, right? So that is what the next shlokam is about. Can one of you read? Kamakshi? Pani.
Mulyam tatkila veshmanam dvijamukhe bhaktyatra yaddiyate veshyanam cha panaha sa eva savane ya dakshina ritvijam padya saiva vishankata bhavati ya padyatra tirtham bhasam dwaram tatra cha tad yadatra karanadwaram pideyam nrinam.
So first vandu he talks about the moolyam, that is the money that you use there to buy houses. So you first go to a city to settle down, you first either rent out a house or you buy a house. So what do you have to do for that? You need money. Now what is the money that will go there in Swargam? First you have to spend so much of money in bhumi for you to get that money there. அத்ர த்விஜமுகே பக்த்யா யது தீயதே தத்கில வேஷ்மனாம் மூல்யம் தத்ர. So whatever you do in பூமி, that is what is going to help you out in the ஸ்வர்கம். So த்விஜமுகே அத்ர, அத்ர பூமௌ, த்விஜமுகே த்விஜானாம் முகே யது தீயதே பக்த்யா ஸ்ரத்தயா, that money which you give out of faith to த்விஜா. Dvija actually means dvir jayate iti dvijaha. So those who have all had the Agnyopavitam are supposed to be twice born. So you have Brahmana, Kshatriya and Vaishya, all three of them. And dvija is also for teeth, because you have a baby tooth and a permanent tooth, right? So dvija is also tooth. The other thing is also pakshi, snakes and all these things which are born first as an egg, and then from the egg they are born. So that is also called twice born. So, but here we take dvija not as Brahmana, Kshatriya and Vaishya only, but here we take dvija as a worthy person. Patratvam. Yesham patratvam vidyate tesham mukhe. So dvija mukhe, in the towards worthy recipients, bhaktya yate diyate, that which is given with faith, with devotion, with the in the sense bhakti is not just I am truly devoted to this Brahmin. Not that is not the point here. Bhakti is you have shraddha on the Vedic texts which enjoin these things, that which says that if you have to give charity to a worthy person, then you will attain the swarga. If you do not have faith in those Vedic texts, then there is no point. That is the bhakti that he is talking about. Not bhakti towards the person whom you are giving, but bhakti towards the Shruti texts that enjoin that if you give charity, you will go to swarga, or you will accumulate a good merit if you do charity. It is good. So that the Vedic text that enjoins this, that you have to follow with Shraddha. So here bhakti is bhakti Shraddha on Shruti. So atra in bhumi bhaktya dvijamukhe yat diyate tatkila veshmanam mulyam. Veshma here is swarga veshmanam, swarga grihanam mulyam tatkila. Tatra is in swarga. நெக்ஸ்ட் வேஷ்யானாம் ச பணஹா ச ஏவ சவனே யா தக்ஷிணா ரித்விஜாம். யூ கோ டு தேர் அண்ட் யூ நீட் விமென், So that's what we started off with, right? So these women, if you want to get them, Veshya Stris, that is the courtesans who are there in the Swarga, you need to give them money also. Now, to give them money there, you have to give Dakshina here. For what? Ritvijam ya savane Dakshina sahayeva. Ritvijam, for the Ritviks. Ritviks are the people who perform the Yajna. Yajna Krit is a Ritvik. And Ritvik is of four types. You have Hota, Udgata, Adhvaryu, and Brahman. So each one is, Hota is the one who follows Rigveda. Udgata is Samavedi. Adhvaryu is a Yajurvedi. And Brahman is Atharvavedi. So these are the four type of people who are called Ritvik. And in a Yagam, you have to have all these four representatives from the four Vedas for you to perform the Yagam. So for those Ritvik, the Yajamana who performs the Yagam has to give Dakshina. The Dakshina or the money that you give to these Ritviks, that forms, that becomes the money in Swargam to give to Veshyas. Ya Dakshina Ritvijam Savane Diyate. Savane in this Yaga. Savane Ya Diyate. Saha Yeva Veshyanam Panaha. Saha, that Dakshina becomes Veshyanam Panaha. Panaha means money. Even in Tamil you have Panam. Panam means money. It comes from Sanskritam here. So padya saeva vishankata bhavati ya padya atra tirtham vasam atra bhumau. So in all three lines you have to take atra as being bhumi and tatra as in swargam. So atra bhumyam tirtham vasam padya ya bhavati tirtham vasam tirtha ambas tirtha sthalangal punyakshetram. So you have to punyakshetram is, or kshetratanam is also part of accumulating, you know, good merits for punyam. For punyam, you go to Tirthasthalam, you give yaga, yajna, you give charities. These are all different types of and different levels of punya karma that you can do in bhumi. The first one is dana, dakshina, dana, dharma, and then this Tirthambasam, kshetratanam is our own bhakti. So Tirthambasam Padya Atra Ya Padya Vartate Bhavati. Tirthambasam, that is the Kshetra Sthalam. Kshetratana Sthalanam Padya Margaha Ya Atra Bhavati. Sayeva Vishankata Padya. So there is a broad path in Amaravati which you can follow or go wherever you want. You will have access to many areas in Amaravati. That's what it means. It's not the literal road. There is already some sort of a road, maybe what that road is, he will say beautifully next time. Now, there is no road as such. So how does all the rathas go? It's only the air that fills up and forms a bed-like thing for the chariots to go, it seems. So Vishankata Padya, here it is not about the physical road in Swargam. You have to take it as Lakshanaya, you have to take the indicated meaning as access, the access point for everything, right? You can't, your access is not limited to certain areas, but you will have a very broad access. Margaha bhavati. So Vishankata Vistrita Padya Sayeva. If you have gone to a lot of kshetras here in Bhumi, then you can go there. Now, what is in dwaram tatra chayat tat yad atra karanadwaram pideyam drinam drinam pideyam karanadwaram atra yad vidyate tat tatra dwaram bhavati. The see, shama dama, you have to practice everything. So first you start off with danam, then you do dakshina. Then you go to Tirtha Kshetrangal, you have bhakti, and from bhakti, you move on to vairagya. He gives you the process. You have to go from the outside to the inside. You can't just stay, you can't just say, I have done a lot of dhanam, then I will go to swarga. No, it is only a limited aspect of swarga that you can enjoy. right? You can live in a good house. Next, you should have given Dakshina, then you can enjoy a bit more. You'll have the apsaras trees serving you. Next, you'll have access to more places if you have gone to Tirtha Kshetras here. So the levels of Satkarma, he keeps on increasing. And the ultimate is Nrinam Karanadwaram, Pideyam Karanadwaram. Atra, in this place, Nrinam, for people, Yadu Pideyam Karanadwaram. The door of Indriyas that have to be closed. So you have to stop outside enjoyment and go towards inside. Bahir Indriya Vyaparam Pidhaya. Karanam is Indriyam. You know why? If you look at Karanam is actually Asadharanam Karanam Karanam. This is from Tarka, where he says there are many reasons for attaining knowledge. The one that is the most useful of it, or the one without which we cannot do. And this is used, Indriya is used only to get the perceptual knowledge of things. It cannot be used for anything else. I don't need to use Indriya for making a pot. Right? For making a pot, what I need is mrit or mud. If I need to make a cloth, I need threads. Those are all a particular cause for a particular effect. That's what it is. Same way, for particular perceptive knowledge of the objects that are there in this world, we need the particular cause, that is Indriyam. That's why he uses the word Karana, which is very specific. You can't just say it is the cause. So Karanam is the particular cause that you need. Here, it is only the Panchendriya with which you enjoy or access, perceive the different objects of the world. You either see Rupam, you smell the Sugandha, Gandha, Rupa, Gandha, Rasa, you taste the taste, the different tastes that are there in the world, you taste it with your tongue. And then Rupa, Rasa, Gandha, Sparsha, you touch the objects and feel and perceive the objects in the world. Rasa, Gandha, Sparsha, Shabda, you hear Shabda. These are the five sense organs, these are the five objects of these sense organs. And so the sense organs, only this particular sense organ can access that particular object. You cannot use your eye to perceive smell. So the eye, Chakshur Indriyam, is a karanam for accessing or for perceiving Rupa. Rupa Pratyaksha Jnane Chakshur Indriyam Karanam Asti, because it is very specific to that particular knowledge. Right? So, Nrinam, for people, you have to first close, you know, after explaining all of this, I'm going to say, close all these Indriyas. Don't even look at the objects that are there in the world. That's what he's trying to say, right? Only when you take all your Indriyas and focus it inward, that is when your entrance to Swargam will be open. Dwaram. See, if you have done Dana, Dakshina, and Kshetratanam and everything, but you have not controlled your sense organs, there is no point. You can't go to Swargam, is what he's saying. But it's actually the reverse. You can even go to Swarga without that. Beyond that, moksham is what you need. This. That's fine. So, yatra, atra, atra is bhumau. Nrinam, manushyanam, pideyam, that which has to be closed. Pideyam, karanadvaram. The method with which Indriyas take the enjoyments, that has to be closed. Pideyam. Tathu, tatra, swarge, dwaram, bhavati. That is the entrance to the houses in Swarga. You can buy a house, you can have women, you can have different access to different places, but you need to go into that house to stay and enjoy. For that, you have to have reverted from the world and focused inside on the Atmaswarupa. That is when you can go there. So these are the steps of Punya Palan, Punya Karma, with which you can attain Swarga. Mulyam Tatkila Veshmanam Dvijamukhe Bhaktya Atra Yat Diyate வேஷ்யானாம் ச பணஹா சயேவ சவனே யா தட்சிணா ரித்விஜாம். I have not mentioned. Okay, there is one more alankara. Just as I am explaining, I see that there is another alankara. If you look at diyate, that word applies to both dvijamukhe bhaktya yate diyate and ritvijam dakshina ya diyate. Since that one single word is common to both prakrita or contextual sentences, that diyate is common. So the alankara here is tulya yogita, which I have not mentioned. So the alankara here is tulya yogita is one alankaram. The other alankaram is karana dwaram. Karanam is indriyam, and indriye dwara aropaha. You superimpose entrance or dwaram on indriya. That's why you have that's why you have a rupaka alankara here. This is the first type of tulya yogita, which is prakritanam kriyapadena samana kriyapadam le. So the example is sankuchanti sarojani swairini vadanani cha. Both the tamare poovum seri pengalnudaiya mukamum seri kamala lotus and the faces are fading. So if you use one kriyapada to describe to connect to contextual happenings, that is called tulya yogita. Okay. Mulyam tatkila veshmanam dvijamukhe bhaktya atra yat diyate veshyanam cha panaha sayeva savane ya dakshina ritvijam padya saiva vishankata bhavatiya padya atra tirthambasam dwaram tatra cha tadyatra tadyad atra yat atra karanadwaram pideyam karanadwaram drunam bhavati tat tatra dwaram cha. So that's how the anvaya goes. Dwaram tatra cha tadyat atra karanadwaram pideyam drunam. Next shloka. Can one of you read?
Asti svadayitum sudhasti vasitum vaso nabhascharinam
charinam
charinam nabhascharinam dhartum santi cha bhushanani shatasho natvasti dhir jivitum yenan yenan nyanu
Anya Anupajivya
Yena Anya Anupajivya Sarva Vibhave Karmaika Kalabhye
Karmaika Labhye
Karmaika Labhye Pade Pyayasyanti Vrithaiva Sevaka Iti Swami Iti Durmedhasaha.
So I told you, right, he has to immediately start off on a sarcastic note. He can't be serious for a long time. I really like this poet. You know, very rarely we can read, enjoy like this by laughing also. It's very rare to find a text like this. Asti swadayitum sudha, asti vasitum vasaha nabhascharinam, dhartum bhushanani santi chatashaha, kintu jivitum dihi na asti. See, he says there are so many good things for these devas. They have the nectar, they have clothes to wear, they have bhushanani dhartum santi, kintu jivitum na dihi asti. Why does he say that? See, they don't want to enjoy all these things that they have. They are constantly fighting. What are they fighting about? I am your servant. You are my servant. I am your Swami. Swami iti, sevaka iti, vrithaiva ayasyanti pade. It is a position that they don't understand, that this position is something that you can get only with sukarma, satkarma. Karmaika labhye pade. And nobody is going to take it away from them. Right? You have got that position because of the karma that you have performed. this atma along with the 17 items that it comes within one patlam, I call it one package. You know, it's a package deal that the atma goes from one shariram to the another. It does not stay as just the atma moves from one shariram to the another. It has a panchendriya, pancha karmendriya, pancha prana, manasu, buddhi. It goes with all of this to another sharira. Now, only those that atma, when in that shariram, performs certain actions, it gets that wealth of swarga. Now, it does not have to depend on anything else. Anya anubhajivya sarva vibhave. The wealth that each person in the swarga have got does not depend on anybody else. Anya anubhajivya. Upajivya is andirkarde. That is, you are dependent on someone. This sarva vibhava, the wealth that he has, is anupajivya. It does not depend anashrita, anya anashrita. He is not dependent on anybody else for their wealth. Karmaika labhye pade, you get this position only by karma. Even then, what do they do? Sevaka iti, swami iti, ayasyanti vrithaiva, out of vain. Useless, so they spend their time in useless fighting. You have your wealth, you get your wealth only because of your actions, and it is only because of your actions in bhumi that you are going to get this wealth. So that's why he started off with the earlier shloka, where he says, whatever you do in this bhumi is what you will get in that swargam. If that is the case, it is very individualistic. I cannot do something and somebody else cannot get the palan. Actually, in Mimamsa, if a person does extraordinary satkarma, the entire clan is actually, they have the, it says, it permeates through seven generations. That's what they say. More than that, I think it's not one person's karma goes to another person. It's more because of that person's karma, they come and they are born in a kulam which has such a legacy. That is the punya phalan, right? So your punya phalan is what you are, the punya that you get is because of the actions that you have performed. So the wealth that you get in swargam is also anya anubhajivya sarva savabhibhave. You are not dependent on anybody else for that wealth. If that is the case, then why do these people fight durmedhasaha? He explains it by saying durmedhasaha. What do you expect of people who don't think about anything else? Dukkha, very difficult. How do you explain that? Durmedhastvam is dustyajatto. You can't, because they cannot leave the vasana. You know, the vasanas or the samskaras with which they have come, even though they have done good deeds in bhumi, the vasana that keeps on coming, what they have fought for in the bhumi, they keep fighting for in the swargam also. That's why they are given the adjective as durmedhasaha, not mahatma chitta. So asti sudha swadayitum asti. There is nectar for the devas, nabhascharinam, nabhasi charanti iti nabhaschari, nabhaha akasha, akashe charanti. So nabhascharinam for the devas, swadayitum sudha asti, to taste they have sudha nectar, vasitum vasaha asti, vasitum to wear, they have vasaha clothes, vasaha. Vasaha is not akaranta. It is vasaha, vasasi, vasamsi. If you would have noticed this word in Gita, vasamsi jirnani yatha vihaya narani grinhati naroparani. Right? So vasamsi is like is clothes. Just like how the moment our clothes become very old, we remove that and take on new clothes. In the same way, the atma also, the shariram is like a cloth for it. So the atma discards its old cloth or old shariram and takes on a new shariram. That is its janma, that is its punarjanma. So vasaha vasitum asti, nabhascharinam for the devas, vasitum in order to wear vasaha asti. They have clothes. Next, shatashaha bhushanani dhartum santi. They have hundreds of different ornaments to wear. But jivitum dhihi na asti. But they don't have any intelligence to live. So that dhihi means intelligence or buddhi. Jivitum, to live. To live or to enjoy what they have. To survive, they don't have the buddhi. See, what does it mean? It's a very, very philosophical phrase that he says. See, in order to survive in the swargam, if you're again going there and talking about possessions, you will be kshine punya martyalokam vishanti. The moment your punya, the merit that you have accumulated, kshine sati, the moment it is completely gone, you will be pushed back into martyaloka. Kshine punye martyalokam vishanti. So you should be very intelligent and think about how to stay there for a long time. Now, how can you stay there for a long time? You should not have attachment. But what do these people do? Sevaka iti, swami iti, karmaika labhye pade ayasyanti. They are doing something completely different. They don't have the brains to live there properly. If you don't show any attachment, you can live there for a long time. That's what it means. So, dihi kintu jivitum, in order to live, dihi na asti. They do not have the intelligence or the brains to live there. Yena, why? Because anya vrithaiva unnecessarily anya upajivya swarva vibhave. Either anya, sorry, anyana upajivya sarva vibhave is another way he changes it, but I don't like that. It's better if it is anya anupajivya sarva vibhave. You cannot earn it from others, nor is it dependent on others. That is what. சரியா, மற்றவர்கள் அண்டி இல்லாத ஒரு செல்வம். கர்மைக லப்யே, this position பதே, this position is attained லப்யே, it can be attained only by karma or actions. சுவாமி இதி சேவக இதி துர்மேதசா ஆயஸ்யந்தி. So people who they are not able to fight their nature. Svabhavaha. You know, that svabhavam is very, very baliya, right? The nature, and the nanachalo nai vala nagutta mudiyadumba. You cannot straighten the tail of a dog. It's an expression in Tamil. So you cannot change certain people's nature. Durmedhasaha, those who have very, I can't say bad intelligence, it's more of a vasana which cannot be forsaken. Those people who whose nature, swabhavam tyaktum, na parayanti, ashaktaha. That is what you have to take as durmedhasaha. Those who cannot forsake their true nature, they ayasyanti, they are constantly putting in effort to say, I am your servant, he is my owner and all that. You know, this sort of an attachment is not a good thing. Here, there is an alankara called Kavyalingam, where Sudha, Vastra, Bhushanadi, Karana, there are two alankaras, one is Visheshokti and the other is Kavyalingam. Kavyalingam is easier, let me explain. So, Swamitwadi Sambandha Vyartha Ayasam Durmedhastvena Samarthanat. Why do they have to keep on fighting for something? The Karmaika Labhye Anya Anupajivya Sarva Vibhave Pade Kimartham Ayasyanti Swami Niti Sevaka Iti Durmedhastvat. You give a Hetu there and you justify your point, then it is Kavyalingalankaram. Visheshokti is Karana Sattve Api Karya Abhava Rupaha Visheshokti Alankaraha. There, Sudha, Vastra, Bhushanadi, Karana, Bahulye Api, Sukhena na Jeevanti. They don't have any, Dihi, Jeevitum Dihi na Asti. You can either say they don't live very happily, they can be very satisfied with whatever they have, but they are not. Right? So, Karana Sattve Api, Karya Abhavaha. Sukha Rupa Karya Abhave, Visheshokti Vakara. Asti Swadayitum, Sudha Asti, Vasitum, Vaso, Nabhascharinam. धर्तुं सन्ति च भूषणानि शतशो नत्वस्ति धीर जीवितुं येनान्य अनुपजीव्य सर्व विभवे कर्मैकलभ्ये फले पदे అపి ఆయాస్యంతి ఆయాస్యంతి వృథైవ సేవక ఇతి స్వామి ఇతి దుర్మేధసః. ఓకే, ఎనీ డౌట్? లెట్స్ మూవ్ టు ద నెక్స్ట్ గద్యం. ராகவி படிக்க முடியுமா பாரு.
பரமாத்பூதம் உத்ரேக்ஷிதம் தஸ்யாம் யத்கில விவித தபஸ் பிரபந்த நிஸ்தந்ததயா விஸ்மித லோகதந்திரேஷு சிர விக்ருத பிரம்மச்சரிய ஜீர்ணதயா காலமத்யுஷு கந்தர்வஸ்ய பிரம்மரிஷி ஹதகேஷு பூதலா ஆகத்ய பிரசக்தேஷு கிரீடிதும் ஆப்சரோனீயம்.
We'll stop with that. See, it's a big paragraph, and at the end, if you see, it says vihasanti vishidanti vilajjante vismayante cha arambhadi menakanta devavarakantaha. Devavarakantaha, the devastri, apsarastri, who are they? Rambhadi menakanta, starting from Ramba, who is the senior most, to Menaka. I don't think Menaka is the junior most, but that's what he says. Apsaras are, there are 14 types of apsaras. There are 14 ancestries. They have come from 14 different people. Like one has come from Surya, the other has come from Chandra, Pavana, Marut, Agni. Sorry, Agni. Daksha had two daughters, Muni and Arishta. They are also apsaras stri kulam. So, Rambhadi Menakanta apsaraha. They are all vismayanti, they are very vihasanti, they laugh at Brahmarshis. So Brahmarshi Hatakeshu, when Brahmarshi, the people who have performed a lot of tapas and everything and brahmacharya vratam in the bhumi, they go to swargam, and looking at their actions, the apsarastris are all laughing at them. They ridicule them. Vishidanti, they are very upset about them. You know, they feel very sad on looking at them. Vilajjante, they are also ashamed of what they are saying, or they feel very shy because of their actions. Vismayante, they are also very surprised by their actions. Why are they surprised? Because these Brahmarshis who have performed and who have accumulated so much of tapas and good karma here in Bhumi, they are unable to let go of their vasanas. Even though this entire passage looks like it is ridiculing the Brahmarshis, he is actually praising them. It's called Vyajastuti. In Vyajastuti, there is a kaste kirtihi yat patakino api swargam niyase. Where is your fame? The poet talks to Ganga and he says, I don't understand why you are so famous. You take all the sinners, pataki namapi swargam nayasi. You take even those people who have performed papa to swargam. Why do people praise you? Now, it is actually not a ninda, but it is a stuti saying even the mahapataki, those who have performed even the mahapatakas, can get moksha if they take up snanam in Ganga, right? Now that keep that in mind whenever he ridicules or nanna brahmarshigalalla thittu varugala. You know why? Idam cha paramadbhutam utprekshitam tasyam. And he starts off with a disclaimer saying, I am only fancied this. It probably is not happening there, but idam parama adbhutam, this very surprising thing, has been fancied, has been imagined. Utprekshitam tasyam amaravatyam maya athava kavibihi parama adbhutam utprekshitam. So people have tried to imagine what could be the scene there when these brahmarshis from the bhumi have gone there to swarga. Yatkila, what is the form of the utpreksha? What is the form of the imagination that he has done? That is, vividha tapav prabandha nistandrataya. Tandra is alasya. So nistandrataya, because they do not have any alasyam, devoid of any laziness, because of the different tapas that they have done, that they have performed. Vividha tapas prabandha nistandrataya. Different types of tapas you have, Chandrayana. There are many types of vratas in that you can perform in the Bhulokam. In order to, manasa pakkuva paduthirudhumba. You train the mind to think in a certain manner. For that, you use these forms of tapas. So, vivida tapas prabandha, performing. Prabandha, because of the performance of different types of tapas, they are devoid of any laziness. Nistandrataya, vismrita lokatantreshu. They have completely forgotten about the lokatantra, the way the world works. Oh, the Brahmarshi Hatakeshu. Hataka is actually a form of censure. He is scolding them. So, Brahmarshi Hatakeshu. Hataka is a kutsita vacham. Hata vidihi are those who do not know the trend. Someone who is not cool. They don't know, they're not trendy, not fashionable. That's what it means. So, Hata vidihi. Brahmarshi Hatakeshu. These people come to Swargam. You know, you should enjoy what is there. They don't know how to enjoy. They are constantly thinking about the tapas that they have done, the Parnashala or the ashrama in which they have stayed, the japam that they have done. They come with that vasana. So their vasana is so strong that even in the presence of such beautiful apsaras, they are not able to forget what they have done. The samskaras is so balavat that they are not able to forget them. So vismrita lokatantreshu, they have forgotten about their worldly pursuits that are there in the bhumi. If it is a person who has engaged in all these things, then he will know how to enjoy in swargam also. Whereas how are these brahmarishis? Vismrita lokatantreshu, chiradhrita brahmacharya jirnataya. They have long taken up the brahmacharya vratam. Brahmacharya vratam is defined by these qualities. Smaranam, kirtanam, kelihi, prekshanam, guhya bhashanam, sankalpaha. These are all the opposite of brahmacharyam. Okay? Lokatantram is this, smaranam. That is, you keep on thinking about a lot of things. That is, that person came and did this to me 20 years ago. I still remember that. I have to get revenge. These are all smaranam. It's not just thinking of God. That's not what he's saying. Kirtanam. Kirtanam is narastuti. You're praising people. Oh, you're wonderful and all that. Kelihi, vilayattugal. That is the krida. Prekshanam, you look at beautiful things. Guhya bhashanam, you talk secret things. Malicious things, gossiping. Guhya bhashanam. Sankalpaha, determination to do things. Vyavasayaha, you engage in actively in doing things, a lot of things in the world. Kriya nirvritihi, or not doing anything also. Just sitting without doing, not in tapas or anything. Just not doing nothing, whiling away your time. And then, etat maithunam, the one who is also, maithunam is engaging in union with other, the opposite sex. So maithunam, ashtangam, this is called 8 different parts for that people perform in this world. Manishinaha pravadanti, etat viparitam brahmacharyam, ashtalakshanam. If asmaranam, akirtanam, akelihi, aprekshanam, you talk of the viparita of all these 8 activities. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. He has talked about 8, and that maithunam, you should take that maithunam as, there are different ways of looking at that maithunam. You can either say it is the union between a man and a woman, or in maithunam, these are the 8 different 8 parts of the union that exists between a man and a woman. So where a man constantly thinks about the woman, smaranam, kirtanam, he talks in praise of the girl, or the girl talks in praise of the man. Kelihi, they engage in play between them. They keep looking at each other. Gukhya bhashanam, they talk in secrets and all that. Right? This is the 8 different parts of maithunam, or union between a man and a woman. Viparitam brahmacharyam. Brahmacharyam is celibacy, where you do not engage in any of these things. So Brahmacharya Vritam, what do these Brahmarshis do? Chira Vidrita. They have constantly been Vidritam. They have been in this by following Brahmacharya for a long time. Jirnataya. They have become old. Kala Mrityeshu Kandarpasya. Kandarpa is Manmatha. The effects of Manmatha have gone to Kala Mrityu. Kala Mrityu is not just the death of one Janma. It is Pralaya Kala Mrityu. That is Kala Mrityu. When the entire world is destroyed, and at that point of time, that Kala Mrityu is the ultimate death. Because these Brahmarshis have been following Brahmacharya for such a long time and they have become old, the effects of Manmatha have gone to its end in them. So, Kandarpasya Kala Mrityushu Brahmarshi Hatakeshu Satsu. These are all Sati Saptami. So when these Brahmarishis, the effects of Manmatha in them have gone to its end. There is no sign of Manmatha in them. That is, you can never bring about the effect of love in them. That's how they are, because they have been following the Brahmacharya Vrata for such a long time.
Here I have a question.
Yes.
That Brahmarshi Hatakeshu, that Hatakeshu part I did not understand. That Hatavidhi.
So Hataka means a person who does not follow any rule. It is like a bad person. Kutsitaha Purushaha. Hatakaha is a Kutsitaha Purushaha.
So then why are they combining that with Brahmarshi?
It is because that they are going to explain why he is saying. See, during how do I explain this? See, it is called Vyaja Stuti. He is not actually censuring them. He is not doing Ninda.
Okay.
See, it is only Stuti. See, they are so the entire passage goes with how they behave during Suratam or Sambhoga. When they are called upon by these Apsara Stris, you know, they have to play with them and be with them. At that point of time, you know, instead of saying, let us go into the house, they will say, let us go into the ashrama. Let loose your hair. Instead of that, they will say, let loose your jata. Instead of veni, they will use words like jata. And then instead of vastram, they will say valkalam. And at the time when you have to, you know, say sweet words, they will keep saying japam. So the one who does not follow the rules that have to be followed during Surata. So Hatavidhi. That is actually used as Bundame Tiriyadavalaka. That is, he doesn't know anything. That's what it means.
Okay.
See, instead of taking it as a censure or a ninda, you take it as a stuti actually. What he wants to convey is a stuti of Brahmarishis. See, normal people in this bhulokam, when they are faced with another woman or a person from the opposite sex, you naturally feel the moment and you go with the moment, right? But these people are unable to enjoy that, or even when they try to enjoy it, they are unable to let go of the vasanas that they have accumulated. So Brahmarishis are so great that they cannot enjoy, even if it is Apsara Stris in front of them, they can't change their usual behavior. That's what it means. So he's not actually scolding them.
Okay, thank you.
Okay, yeah. So Brahmarshi Hatakeshu Bhutalat Agatya. They have come from the Bhutalam. Apsarovihi Kriditum Prasakteshu. When they have started to play with the Apsaras. Apsarobihi saha, along with the Apsaras, kriditum prasakteshu, when they are involved in playing with the Apsaras. Now what happens to them? That's why I said, Brahmarshi hatakaha ninda mukena satkarma vrata achara mokshaparayanadi vasana balat sanmarge eva pravrittaha iti stampi. So he does not nindate. He doesn't censure them. He actually stotram karoti. I'll go back to the Vyaja Stuti at the end of the passage also. Okay. So the next one. Can you read that? I think we will stop with this because once we go into this, it is a series. So what do they do when they start playing with the apsaras? That part we will see in next class.
Okay. Pardon? Shall I read?
No, I think we will do that next class. Is that okay?
Okay, sure.
Yeah. If I start now, then we can probably do one or two lines only. I might as well deal the whole thing next class. Huh? Along with
yeah.
the Alan. Okay.